How pleased are you now that Fernando is racing for Renault this year? He's really making one last big effort in Formula One. What does that mean to you, and how do you think he will go?
You know, Fernando is very fit. Apart the accident he made with the bike.
Yeah.
I tell Fernando, I talk with him every day, you know. I tell Fernando to stop with this bike because it's very... These bikes are very dangerous. If you want to go, you go in the mountain bike, not to go in the road, the street. I tell you, if you don't stop with the bike, I lock you in the garage. Not the bike, I lock you in the garage. But Fernando is very fit. He's very, very motivating. I believe that 2 years out of Formula One for him was good. Because first, he's re-motivating again, no? Especially when you're driving the car, have not the possibility to win. It's a lot of frustration for a driver like that, you know? Because I believe if you put at least 6 or 7 drivers in the Mercedes team, 6 or 7 Formula One, the possibility to win the championship. Now the car is so predominant respect to the skill of the driver, you know? And Fernando, we know, Renault, we had the guarantee from Renault. In the meantime, Luca De Meo is the chairman of Renault. It's very motivating to invest in money in Formula One for long term. Because Renault have always this word, you know, Renault, yes, it's good, but he don't have the money, he don't have this, you know. With me, Renault was very good because whatever money I needed, I have it. Sure. The money go in the performance of the car. You know, at my time, I had the worst motorhome in the Formula One because, I mean, if you have a good motorhome, it'll make you go quick the car, you know?
Agreed.
I prefer spending all the money in the performance. But I'm happy for him because Renault is a family, you know? When we talking with Renault, everybody was very happy and everybody is very motivating. I mean, it's been interesting to see what's going on in 2000, I think tomorrow 2021, in 2022, because in 2022 we shuffle the card yeah. again, you know. Now, this year is a transaction year, but Fernando is ready to go. You see the test, he may have in Bahrain after the season was very quick immediately. So and Fernando was driving all the time, was driving car all the time, was racing all the time.
Yeah.
I mean, unfortunately, happened this accident, but it's not really. Yesterday already was in Lugano, and today was walking again. It's fine. I believe he's ready for the first test already, you know, not for the first race.
Does he have a problem? Does he have a problem to talk with the injury here?
No. He's talking very well. No problem. The problem is here. He break 2 teeth here. But he was very lucky because, you know, this bike now is very, it's very dangerous because the print in the tarmac is very, the tire, the print is 1 centimeter, you know. Braking is difficult. I mean, very, very lucky. So, God was watching him, and today was talking perfectly. Only one day because of the mask with the eyes. This was only one day was not able to talk. Man, it's normal. He's recovering completely.
Did he have the accident on his own, or was he hit by somebody else, or a car or something?
No, he crashed against the car.
Did he?
Yeah.
Very lucky, as you say. Very lucky.
Lucky. You remember when it happened to Aiden, the motorbike driver, with Mark Webber?
Yeah, in Tasmania,
Mark
yeah.
Mark Webber. With Zanardi, you know, Zanardi again, you know.
Yeah.
I believe, you know, you have a destiny in life. Him escape. I'm very happy. I'm sure we see him in the first test. I think so, the 13, we had the first test. He's been there.
Flavio, the other interesting thing is that the team he's driving for, Renault, is still a little bit Your team from the Benetton days, Alain Permain and a few of the boys are still there, the same character. And Renault now just doing an engine exclusively for that team, no customers at all. That could be good, it could be bad. I think in this occasion, personally, I think that's probably quite a good thing. They can really focus on this year. What are your thoughts on that?
And this is the difference between the team at my time and now. At my time, we win the championship.
True.
No, it's, you know, Renault is motivated to doing a good engine, and I believe in the right way to go, you know.
I was reflecting the other day on how it must have been for you when basically you created the environment for Michael to win with. And then eventually he went off to Ferrari, having won two championships with you. And then what really impresses me looking back now is how you then dug very deep and you created another Michael, which was called Fernando Alonso. And I think that the way you did that, looking back now, is very, very impressive. And I wanted to just talk to you about that time and really about the first, what your emotions were after Michael left, and then looking for somebody like Fernando. And then when you found Fernando, what is it about Fernando that made you believe in him?
Well, you know, Peter, it's like you're doing a movie with the same director, no? Because it was about the same, if you see. Michael, you know, at the time was a kind of forced market because Benetton have no credibility to hire people like Senna, like Prost, like Gerhard Berger, because first we don't have the money. And second one, we still had the reputation of the T-shirts maker.
Yeah.
So, in all this technical environment, you remember Ron Dennis telling me all the time, you don't have the race in your stomach, you know, and might have the management skill, was better than not have the engine, the engine in the stomach. So, I was, at the time, I need found somebody to grow with the team. It's like in the football now, you know, now you have people of 17 years old play with the top team. And the idea for me was looking what it was the young, promising driver for Formula One. And we're looking the Group C, we're looking the Mercedes, we're looking for the team of Peter Sauber. And at the time, the three more, if you want, the talent driver was Wendlinger, was Frentzen, it was Michael. So everybody was pushing more or less for Frentzen because it looked like Frentzen was more promising guy. And in the end, I decided to have Michael Schumacher in the team. And Schumi was sensational for us, you know, because it was very quick, immediately. The engineering have incredible feedback for very young driver. And this give us the possibility to have a lot of sponsor for German as well. You remember, we have Bitburger, the beer, the first sponsor. So this was the idea. The team was very exciting to have two drivers like that. Mm. Every race we go, we have two cars. Normally, we have only one car in Benetton. We build in two cars, but we're using one. You don't need a genius to understand, you need to have two cars like everybody else. So this was a little bit the story of Michael.
And then Michael was very successful, and then basically Jean Todt, Ross Brawn, Michael, everybody left to go to Ferrari, and you were left then having to find a new driver, and you focused on Fernando quite early on. Tell me about Fernando and how you first knew about Fernando and how you first met him.
He's coming to see me. Fernando was driving in Spain, you know, with the go-kart and this, and was signed by Minardi. I talked with Giancarlo Minardi, and at the time, I with Renault, you know, And the market, Renault Spain, was very strong. I think so Spain was the strong market after France for Renault. And I talked with Giancarlo Minardi, and Giancarlo told me, the guy is very, very good. And I called Campos. You know, Campos just died a few weeks ago.
Poor Adrian, yeah, lovely guy.
Lovely guy, super. And the boat arriving in my house in London. So I proposed to Fernando to be part of the team, to be part of the management as well, because with the management we control the driver. And at one point Fernando Campos tell me, we go back, we're thinking about. I told, no, you don't go back, you're not thinking about, you just sign. And both signed the agreement. After that I call Minardi. I tell Minardi to keep Fernando in the team. We give a loan to Minardi to have Fernando, and immediately doing very well in Minardi. You remember that Minardi was fighting 7-8 position, was a good fighter. So I believe it was the same movie we done with Michael, we need to do with Renault with Fernando. At the time, I have a Jenson Button, you remember? Jenson Button was very supported by the British press. You know, was a new driver for UK and a nice guy, you know, with Jenson, no problem at all. But I believe for the future of the Renault was better Fernando and not Jenson. So I not renewed the contract with Jenson, I take Fernando. All the UK press killed me. You remember, you know, I tell in the press conference with the UK journalist, talking about, okay, guys, I made the decision. Only the future tell me if I was wrong or was right. And it looked like I was right.
You were very right. You were very right. What was Fernando like in those early days, Flavio? How was he? What sort of personality?
You know, when you have a talent, it's the same as Shumi. You know, when you have a talent, the talent is something very special, because all the drivers in Formula One are quick. But the line to be a superstar, a good driver, is very thin. And Fernando, that's Shumi. Whatever you put in the computer, you know, you're doing the simulation of the race. And in the computer, you do it with the computer, you do it the robot. Yeah? Fernando was doing the same time. We know that when the tire go out, in doing the timing. When the tire go out, we do the timing. It was the preparation of the race with Fernando and with Shumi. It's like the computer tell you what's going on. The consistency in the lap time was very impressive by Shumi and by Fernando. Me, I was lucky to have I miss Ayrton Senna. But I was lucky to work with the two best talent at the time. And the motivation was the same. The physical, another one, Shumi make everybody to go to the gym. Because before, you remember, the gym was, Prost in the beach doing some exercise. You know? Michael was 4 hours in the gym. 4 hours in the gym. And when Michael was finishing the race, was not sweating. And Fernando as well. And Michael make everybody go back in the gym, from Ayrton Senna to Alain Prost to Nigel Mansell to everybody, because physically, Michael demonstrated to everybody the physical preparation was very important, because if you fit, your mind is much better, and not you tired, not when you're driving the car.